Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, dear respected brothers and sisters. Subhanallah, how fast the days and nights of Ramadan have gone. And here we are toward the end of the month of Ramadan. And our messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, innama al-a'mal bil-khawatim, that verily actions will be judged by their ending. This hadith should motivate us to exert our efforts in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the final days and the final nights of the month of Ramadan. And mainly, sincerely ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us our Ramadan. Because what matters at the end of the day is the acceptance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We find Ibrahim alayhim and Ismail alayhim as-salatu was-salam, as they were rebuilding the Kaaba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that when they were in the process of fulfilling the command of Allah, they were supplicating sincerely, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا, O Allah, accept from us, إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ, you are the all-hearing, the all-knowing. And Allah says, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ, that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts from those who are mindful of Him, from those who are fearful of Him. And as we're getting close to Eid, many of us feel a sense of sadness, a sense of grief, that this Eid will not be the usual Eid that we're used to, that we'll not be able to come to the masajid and celebrate the Eid with our community. And I want to remind the brothers and sisters, when the Prophet ﷺ migrated to Medina with our beloved companions, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, they remained in Ghar Thawr for 3 days. And as they were in Ghar Thawr, Abu Bakr sensed the threat of Quraysh surrounding the cave. He feared for the Prophet. He was worried for the Prophet ﷺ, not himself. So the Prophet ﷺ looked at him and he said, مَا بَالُكَ فِثْنَيْنَ اللَّهُ ثَالِثُهُمَا لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعْنَا. What do you think of two? Allah is their third. Do not be worried and do not be sad. Allah is with us. So this is the message I want to deliver to all my brothers and sisters, to all those who are watching this video. لا تحزنوا إن الله معنا, that do not be sad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you. You as believers believe in the decree of Allah, and you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decree is never separated from His wisdom, that everything happens for a reason, and for a reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, and that every difficulty we go through is not separated from the kindness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا, إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا, that verily with hardship there is ease. And Allah assured it again, verily with hardship there is ease. This is what we believe as believers, as those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the hardship has ease with it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions to us in Surah Al-Baqarah that He will test us with something of fear, with something of hunger, a loss of wealth, a loss of lives. And Allah says, Bashir al-Sabirin, give glad tidings to those who remain patient, those who say when they are afflicted with any type of trial, we belong to Allah and to Him we shall return. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, Inna Safa wal Marwa min Sha'airillah, that the Safa and Marwa are of the signs of Allah. Why is Allah mentioning this after He talks about the trials and tests and the importance of being patient? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here presents the example of Hajar alayhi salam. When Ibrahim, he listened and followed the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to leave Hajar and Ismail alayhim as-salam in the barren land, in the scorching heat, in a land that was empty. There was no type of life there. But Hajar, she knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with her, and he will not leave her and Ismail alone. And subhanallah, when Ismail was crying out of hunger, out of thirst, Hajar panicked. Hajar became worried. She started looking for any type of sustenance for Ismail. And as she was looking for the sustenance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought the relief from a place that she was not even looking for, from a place she didn't even expect, from beneath Ismail alayhi salam, to remind us that whoever fears Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a way out for him. And Allah will make a way out for us. We have to be hopeful and hope in Allah's mercy. Allah will lift this pandemic and soon we'll be reunited again in the masajid. But we could still make this Eid a special one, even though we are in our homes. So let's make sure that we wake up early, we dress ourselves and our children with beautiful clothes, that we pray together as a family, and even get more creative and perhaps decorate our homes and, you know, fill the house with the spirit of Eid. That is really, really crucial. And at the end of the day, we need to make sure that we do not make the kids feel like this Eid doesn't exist. They will feel it's different, but we can make it definitely Eid that is special. And at the end of this video, I want to remind my brothers and sisters to support Why Islam and all the hard work they do in presenting the da'wah of Allah and in presenting Islam in a beautiful way to Muslims and non-Muslims. And we ask Allah to reward them for all the efforts they do, support them, especially during this month of giving. And we ask Allah to accept from us all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We're here at the end of the first day of the NJEA convention. Just a quick update. So far within the last few hours, we managed to give away over 500 Quran and over 2,500 pamphlets. We've had some great conversation. We've managed to really, really bring awareness to the cause we're trying to do over here, which is basically Muslim children, you know, whatever difficulties you're going through in school. Great conversations. We've gotten a lot of great perspective, great stories, and inshallah we're looking forward to tomorrow. Assalamu alaikum.